Hello children, let's continue with the chapter 15, our constitution. The last paragraph in our preamble tells us that the people of India have given themselves this constitution. The constitution of India promises every Indian citizen certain basic human freedoms. These are called fundamental rights. These rights are given to all citizens irrespective of race, caste, gender and religion. Some of the fundamental rights are right to equality, right to freedom, right to education, right to freedom of religion, cultural and educational rights, rights to constitutional remedy. There are some fundamental rights: the right to equality and justice, the right to practice any religion, the right to freedom, freedom to live anywhere in India, freedom to do any kind of work, freedom to speak, read and write, freedom to practice one's own customs and traditions, the right to get educated, the right to vote if one is 18 years or above, the right to get good medical care. Child labor is not allowed. Adults who employ children below 14 years of age to do work, especially against wages, can be punished. We should always remember this. Our constitution has provided us so many basic rights. We should be grateful to our country and never misuse them. The Constitution of India has also listed the fundamental duties expected of every citizen. Each one of us must take care of our duties very seriously. Here are some fundamental duties. Show respect for the laws laid down in the Constitution. Show respect for the national flag and the national anthem. Stand up straight while the anthem is being sung or played. Do not speak or fidget at that time. Try to protect the freedom and unity of our country. We should not do anything that will disturb the peace of our nation. We should be prepared to defend our country if there is a threat from external forces. We should value, protect and preserve our rich heritage and culture. We should not misuse our natural resources. We should look after all public property. We should ensure that our activities do not harm the environment. Most importantly, we should get along well with people from different parts of India, no matter who we are, rich, poor, man or woman or child. We must live in harmony. We should maintain peace and settle our quarrels in a non-violent manner. We should always keep peace, settle all quarrels with non-violence. Apart from our rights and duties, our constitution also has detailed guidelines meant for the union and state governments. The history behind this is the concept of directive principles of state policy was borrowed from the Irish Constitution. The makers of the Constitution of India were influenced by the Irish nationalist movement. The principles have been inspired by the directive principles given in the Constitution of Ireland and also by the principles of Gandhism and relate to social justice, economic welfare, foreign policy, and legal and administrative matters. These are directive principles of state policy. These directives are to ensure that all citizens of India are well taken care of. States must provide adequate opportunities for employment. States must ensure that wealth is more or less equally spread among its citizens and non-concentrated in the hands of a few people. States should provide free education to all children below the age of 14 years. State must formulate programs for the economically weaker sections of society so that they can progress in life. States must guarantee basic health services, especially for the weaker sections of society, including old people. A vast country like India, with such a diverse culture, need to have detailed laws and guidelines. That is why the world's largest democracy, that is, in India, has such a long constitution. The Indian Constitution is the longest written constitution in the world. It has 395 articles and 12 schedules, several amendments. Some points to remember. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar is the chief architect of the Indian Constitution. The Indian Constitution came into effect on 26 January 1950. India officially became a republic on that day. The first page of our Constitution is called the Preamble. It is an introduction to the rest of the book. The Constitution of India promises every Indian citizen certain basic human freedoms. These are called fundamental rights. The Constitution of India has also listed the fundamental duties expected from every Indian citizen. The directive principles of state policy are detailed guidelines which the union and state governments must follow to ensure the welfare of all Indian citizens.